Hello and welcome to today's video break. In Psalm 37 verse 32 it says, "The wicked lie in wait for the righteous, intent on putting them to death." That's kind of a scary passage, but it's interesting because have you ever noticed this growing irritation to Christianity in the world we live in? Now, for some reason, some of it's justified. I get it. You know, there's some radical people out there that I think just wish would just hush. And, you know, an unloving sort of matter. But, the group I'm talking about, the people who are unloving, you know, pretty dogmatic in their faith, that's just wish would be quiet. But this isn't what Jesus is talking about, or excuse me, David is talking about in this passage. It's the wicked cannot stand those who walk in righteousness. There's a rub there. And I think part of it's because, you know, we're children of light and God has put his light in us. And so light, what does it do? It exposes darkness. And so when we're walking in love in the world that we live in, just that very fact, you know, the ability that we can have to love our neighbor, you know, to forgive 7 times 70, those kinds of things are irritating to those who don't want to live that way, you know, who want to live for vengeance, who want you know, that action that is less than righteous. And so sometimes even our words speak so much truth that it brings lies, it exposes lies. And so that's a rub against the wicked. And so they do lie in wait, ways to ruin the righteous. But we don't need to allow that to scare us because Jesus knew very well what it was like to have, he was, you know, the righteous one, and yet he was the wicked lie waited for him. Where, you know, just, you know, you can just see his life in the way that they just waited for him to fall. And, you know, and so they could capture him and they could arrest him. And we know the rest of the story. That's exactly what happened. But in our life, we continue to walk in righteousness regardless of the persecution that's before us. And that can be extremely difficult. But remember, it's not only you that they're persecuting. It's not only you that they're coming after. It's righteous people, righteous living, which is insulting to those who aren't living righteously. It almost feels shameful. And so the way that they deal with their shame is to come after the righteous because they don't want to be exposed. You know, they want to keep hidden. They want their, you know, and it's kind of sad. So my encouragement for us is to continue walking in love. And, you know, when somebody slaps us on the cheek, offer the other side too. You know, somebody wants our cloak, give them the cloak. Love your enemies is what Jesus said. And that's a hard thing to jump over. But when we're not loving them, then we're playing the same games they are. You know, we're going down the same path that they are, which is hate and strife and all those ugly things. So, friends, will you walk with me in this journey that we can truly learn to love those, love our enemies?